That's right, everybody. Maya and I are reunited once again. And today, we're gonna be talking about how Jeffree Star manipulates the drama channels. But if you're just here for the drama, if you're just here for the tea, you're in the wrong place, baby girl, because we are here to teach you about the inner workings of the human mind. And it might help you not get manipulated in the future. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel's all about mental health. So yeah, I pull different topics from the YouTube community, but I'm not here to just gossip and spill tea and all that. I like to discuss what we can learn from these situations to improve our own mental and emotional well-being. And in this video, the specific topic is getting manipulated without even realizing it. All right, so if you're into that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And if you're not yet, follow me over on Instagram and Twitter at The Rewired Soul. And as you can see, all you loyal Rewired soldiers, I am back home in Las Vegas after being out of town for a week for the holidays. And thank you all for, you know, following me on social media. I talked to a bunch of you while I was gone, and you know, any of you who were struggling with the holidays and everything, had some great conversations with you guys. All right, so yeah, what inspired this video is obviously there's a lot of stuff going on with people like Rich Lux and Luscious, and somebody just sent me Ashley Kyle's video and everything. But like, I made a promise to all of you, and that promise was, I will not turn on this camera and make a video unless I can provide you with some value. So as I was watching Ashley Kyle's video, she said this.
I started receiving PR during the Jawbreaker collection. That was my first PR package. So I always felt so respected by him. And I'm just the kind of person where if you respect me, I'm gonna respect you back. And did that create some bias? Yes, it did. Like, I guess it did. Yeah, it did. And it shouldn't be that way at all. And that's not acceptable. And at the time, I don't even think I really realized I was doing it until everybody was calling me out for it, calling everybody out for it. I was like, damn, they're right.
So again, although I'm using this as context for the situation, I want you guys to realize how this might be happening in your own life or in the world as a whole. All right, because some things I'll circle back to a little bit later after we jump into some of the psychology, evolutionary, you know, psychology and stuff like that. We're gonna double back and talk about why, you know, drug companies send doctors such nice gifts. Why, you know, different industries like the tobacco industry or big pharma, you know, make such nice campaign contributions. You know what I mean? And also, you know, I come from a background of sales and marketing, and I'll discuss some of the other situations, you know, I've seen. But anyways, what I want to recommend to all of you, if you find this video interesting, check out this book called Moral Tribes. It's a long book. It was the longest book that I've read in a long time, and I was like, oh, this is gonna be boring, but I just could not stop reading it, all right? So, like you saw from that clip, something Ashley Kyle mentioned was, you know, she was just on Jeffree Star's PR list, and she realized that she wasn't making certain videos about Jeffree Star, right? And this is something that all of us run into, okay? So some of you who have taken a psychology class, you've heard of the prisoner's dilemma. This is in psychology classes as well as like philosophy classes, all right? So there's a bunch of different versions of the prisoner's dilemma. Like in that book, Moral Tribes, there's actually like a really long chapter on just all the different versions of the prisoner's dilemma. So let me just give you like the most basic version of it, all right? So two dudes go and rob a bank, right? They get caught by the police, okay? They put them both in different interrogation rooms. They go up to one of the dudes, call him John, and say, hey John, all right? You're looking at 10 years, but if you rat out your boy Bob, you're only gonna get 5 years, right? And then they go over to Bob and they're like, yo Bob, you're looking at 10 years, but if you rat out your boy John, you're only gonna get 5 years. So this is the prisoner's dilemma, right? Does John, you know, betray his partner in crime for a lesser sentence? But John also has to consider that Bob might be getting the same offer, and he has to take into consideration, what is Bob going to do, right? The prisoner's dilemma. And the best case scenario is that they both don't say squat, all right? So they've recreated this in a bunch of different ways, but eventually they took the prisoner's dilemma and they did it with computers, right? To see which situation was the best. And that's when they came up with the saying, tit for tat, all right? Tit for tat. We all know what that means, right? And that is do what other people are doing. You kind of mirror the other person's behavior. They've also done more experiments with people and a game with like money, right? And it was like pennies or whatever. They put a bunch of people in different places and it's like, how much are you contributing to the pot? And you could take some out too. And what they saw was people mimic other people's behavior. So the more you take, the more I'm gonna take. The more you put in, I'm gonna put in, all right? So why do we do this? Why do we do this as human beings? Because of something called reciprocity, all right? So from an evolutionary standpoint, like we are designed to survive and pass along our genes. That's it. Those are our two main priorities. Live long enough to pass on your genes. So what evolutionary psychologists are looking at is like, so how did tribes form? Why did these form? And this is something talked about in moral tribes even more. So there's me versus you, right? Me versus you. But the thing is, we get a lot more done if we work together, okay? Then there becomes us versus them. And that's when you kind of see the tribal aspect, tribe against tribe. So me versus us, or me versus you doesn't really work too well, but us versus them, that works a little bit better. And that's when you saw, you know, different empires throughout history and everything, whoever had the best cohesion. So that allowed them to survive, have more power and control, pass along those genes. So the reason why we do good things for other people is to promote cooperation, right? Because people back in the day, if they didn't cooperate, boop, they got booted out of the tribe, baby girl, all right? So what does this mean? What does this mean? So when you look at people like, you know, all of the beauty influencers, right? You got Jeffree Star, you got Tati Westbrook, Shane Dawson just came out with his palette, you know, and you got James Charles and Jaclyn Hill. So let me make this very clear, all right? Especially for the people in the back. I am not assuming anybody's intentions, okay? I am not going to assume anybody's intentions, not Jeffree Star's, not Tati Westbrook's, not James Charles, none of that, okay? You can come to your own conclusion, okay? But what I'm getting at is, like, at our most basic level, we are designed for reciprocity, all right? Somebody gives something to us, okay? We feel indebted to do something nice to them. That is how we are wired, okay? So these PR kits that are just sent out to drama channels, it begins this kind of unconscious bias. And as you saw with Ashley Kyle, she didn't even recognize it was happening. But I want you to look at your own life. Like how many people, like maybe it's a family member, maybe it's a friend, maybe you've stayed in a relationship so long because of that internal feeling of reciprocity, right? Like maybe your mom lets you live with her for a while, right? I'm using my own example real quick. Like my mom, when I first got sober, she let me live with her, like rent free. You know what I mean? I feel indebted to her, okay? Maybe you are in a relationship, maybe a toxic relationship. And this is when some people know that. They know that about human nature and they hold it over your head, right? Maybe you stayed in an abusive relationship too long because they paid the bills and they did this and they did that. They took care of this, blah, blah, blah. And then they shove it in your face. Or even if they don't shove it in your face, maybe again, on that kind of subconscious level, you feel indebted to them, okay? But going back to what I was talking about in the beginning, because I'm not gonna assume the intentions of anybody from Jeffree Star to Tati to James to Jaclyn Hill or anybody, but this is just how we're designed. Now, like the big pharma, for example, a lot of you know that I'm a recovering opioid addict, right? Like I have a big issue with big pharma and their campaign contributions, okay? Because they can't flat out say Purdue Pharma, the place that's, you know, going bankrupt because they're paying billions of dollars for the opioid epidemic, they can't just go up to a senator and say, here's 500 grand, all right? Make sure that you don't let any bill pass that might regulate pharmaceuticals. They can't say that. We call that bribe. But you can make a campaign contribution, right? The NRA, you can make a campaign contribution. Big Tobacco, make a campaign contribution because of reciprocity, okay? Like I said, like next time you're in your primary care doctor's office, check around their office. See how many notepads or pens they have with names of medications on them. Like, if you've been in a doctor's office for a while or if you've worked in a doctor's office, you've seen representatives come and give out swag and things like that. Like, part of it is just a visual reminder, all right? Like, oh, hey, my pen, and then, you know, that gets stuck in your brain, that certain medication. But sometimes it's reciprocity, right? Oh, this representative always brings me pens. And if you worked in the office, you know how people be stealing pens, right? So, oh, they bring me pens all the time. Some people even bring food. They bring donuts, they bring coffee, they bring all this stuff. So when I was working for the Addiction Treatment Center, we were nationwide, and we had reps in every major city where, not only where we had treatment centers, but in other parts of the country, because we had people coming in from all over the country, going to different facilities. We had facilities from California to Florida, right? But we had reps that would go around to the different hospitals, different therapists, anybody who might give us a referral, right? And these reps would go there, they'd give them swag, they'd buy them food, they'd buy them lunch. Why? Because the next time you get a drug addict in the emergency room, you'll remember to send them our way. You see what I mean? It's reciprocity, okay? So I thought this was the perfect time. When I was watching Ashley Kyle's video, I was like, huh, this is a perfect time to discuss this. So again, I highly recommend, like, if you wanna learn more about this topic, and Moral Tribes is more about morality. I just kind of dove into the prisoner's dilemma and cooperation and everything like that. But that book goes so much further. It starts talking about, you know, liberals and conservative views and where they stand on certain things. Because once you understand that, you start understanding different people's opinions on things and why they view things. Like, do you ever sit back at somebody and say, how could any logical person even think like that? Well, once you start learning about moral psychology and moral philosophy, all that stuff starts to click. You know what I mean? So if you're a nerd like that and you wanna get into it, go for it, okay? But, like, just be mindful. I'll end with you on this. Like, way back in the day, I was one of the biggest Kanye West fans, all right? One of the biggest Kanye West fans. He had a book that came out. I forgot what it was called. It was this very small book. It was almost like Chicken Soup for the Soul. It was very small. He just had little quotes and everything like that, right? But one of the things that he said was, he never asked anybody to be on a track with him. And this is back in the day, so I don't know if he's changed his philosophy on this. This is like way back, like college dropout times, right? But he doesn't ask people to be on a track with him, right? Because then he'll feel like he owes them something, right? And, you know, he's a smart dude, all right? He might be a little off his rocker now and then, but he's a smart dude. But that's the thing, like, something that I've tried to do pretty much since I got sober, is become fully self-supporting. So that way I'm not indebted to anybody, right? I don't like owing anybody anything because it can skew my, you know, my actions, my thoughts, the things I do, all these things. You know what I'm saying? So just keep that in mind. So I'm not saying don't take the free PR. Take that free PR, baby girl. But just keep in mind, on a subconscious level, you might have that reciprocity going on. You know what I'm saying? Anyways, glad to be back. Make sure you're following me over on Instagram and Twitter at The Rewired Soul. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And a big, big thank you to everybody who supports the channel over on Patreon, as well as everybody who supports the channel by buying my books over at TheRewiredSoul.com, and everybody who gets Rewired Soul merch. And by the way, we got hoodies and pullovers and everything like that. So if you're chilly this winter, go check out The Rewired Soul shop. All right, thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time.